Well, what you see in front of me isn't actually have to do with this video. I was setting up for something else, but then some news dropped about the CR10, about Creality, and about the GPL. Naomi Wu tweeted earlier, "Little going away present for my 3D printing peeps. Creality 3D CR10S source code took a bit of work." Naomi then linked to the CR10S source code in a RAR file and tagged a bunch of cool 3D printing people. What's really cool about this is, one, it's not some sort of reverse engineered thing from a hex file. It's not some sort of ROM dump. This is the actual Marlin source that Creality used and then compiled to run the CR10S. And the reason the CR10S is important in this is because it includes the filament sensor and it includes the power out recovery. This is really exciting news because while Creality makes great machines, they were using Marlin and they weren't adhering to the license that Marlin is released under. There's been some talk about how Creality chose to go into business with a Beijing company who was then doing the development and then handing them the hex files, which meant that company was then not adhering to the GPL, which then meant Creality was just using stolen software. It gets really, really confusing fast. First, before we go any further, I just want to say, this is a massively great thing. This is Creality 3D listening to a community and then giving back. Not only that, this is a Chinese company listening to a lot of Western feedback. This is so, Creality could have just ignored us. Creality could have placated us and just went with the CR10 source that they released through Naomi Wu earlier, or they could choose to do the right thing. I was privy to some internal conversations, and it's very important to note that while the community pressure was very, very vital in getting Creality to do the correct thing, it was Naomi Wu being the liaison and explaining to Creality and Mr. Chen and everybody over there what the GPL is, why it's beneficial, what Creality doing isn't correct, and how, let's face it, by going legit with Marlin, Creality then wouldn't have to pay money to this Beijing software house. Creality could, in fact, save money by going legit. In response to that tweet, Chris Russell did ask if this was taken source or if this was freely given source, and Naomi responded with, "They're trying, but none of the bosses speak English, and there's just a ton of things going on. None of it malicious. I've spent hours going over GPL with them, and I'm still not sure it's clear yet, but they responded to the community and plan to continue to do so." That last part of Naomi Wu's tweet is just incredible and nearly gives me chills. Not only did Creality listen to the community, they're planning to continue to do so, and they're planning to move forward. That's incredible. A Chinese printer manufacturer adhering to open source and welcoming community input. This is fantastic. One more tweet down the line that I'd like to talk about. Naomi Wu says, "I think the boycott was absolutely the right tool, but for now in any videos, rolling the back would be something I could show them as direct cause and effect and make it clear it will happen again if things don't improve." Creality is making an effort to listen to the community and to adhere to some standards of openness. I think that's great. They gave Naomi the CR10S source code to give out, and I think that is an incredibly good faith gesture in wanting to continue to work with the community and to adhere to the GPL. I think Creality sending a CR10S to Scott of the Marlin team so he can do development on their machine is brilliant. I think there's a lot of really good stuff going on. And since Creality did put forth a good faith effort in the CR10S source code and sending a CR10S to the Marlin development team, I will remove the GPL violation thumbnail from the CR10 review that I have, and I will remove the GPL violation text in the title and the description. I think that Creality is leading the way. I think Creality is doing a good thing. And it's important to note, the reason we're at this place that we are today is because of two very important things. One, community pressure on Creality. I never called for a boycott. In fact, I recommended you to just print everything and still buy their printers. However, others did. Others made videos. There was a global community pressure for Creality to do the right thing. Second, I think we owe a huge debt of gratitude to Naomi Wu. No one at Creality, I believe is what she said, speaks English. And for her to interface with Creality for hours about the GPL, about open source, about Marlin, about ways that being open and using Marlin and its open standard could benefit the company and save them money, it's great. Naomi, thank you. That's just a quick update from my end. I think we're taking the right path here. And if the path continues, it's going to be amazing. Thanks for watching. And if you didn't know, I guess now you do. Print all the things. I love you guys. As always, high five.